First of all, very glad to be back in person. After 3 years now, pre-pandemic, we hadn't had in-person legacy luncheon, so glad to see everybody's bright, shiny faces, not like mine. We have a very special treat today with the Magic City Quartet. Thank you guys for coming. Which is an ensemble of the Alabama Symphony Orchestra performing some light classics for us. The selection of this program was very intentional. Our congregation has a long tradition of musical appreciation and excellence, and we wanted to also pay tribute to two of our long-term endowment patrons who passed away during the pandemic, who both absolutely loved music. Ruth Engel, and most recently, Joan Jacobson. Both created funds to support our cultural arts programming at our congregation. Cantor Whitner will speak more about those two lovely matriarchs of music later in today's program. With that, I'm gonna turn it over to Lisa Weinhold and the Alabama Symphony. Thank you very much. Take it away.
Thank you. Thank you very much. My name is Lisa Weinhold. I'm the principal flutist of the Alabama Symphony Orchestra, and my colleagues here are Mary Del Gobo on cello. Get out of the way. Renee Reeder on viola, and Mayumi Masri on violin. We are very happy to be here. I recognize many of your faces from seeing you in our audiences. And that first piece was by Handel. It's called Les Réjouissances from the fireworks music. It means rejoicing, and we're truly rejoicing to be back here playing for you all in person. It's just a real pleasure. So the next piece we're going to play for you, I think many of you will recognize as well. It's a little bit of Mozart, and it's Eine kleine Nacht music, which is a little night music, the first movement of that. We're gonna have to turn it into a little daytime music for today, but it's a lovely piece, and we hope you enjoy it. It's important to have the right music up. There we go. Thank you. Next, we're going to move back a time period back into the Baroque era, and we're going to play a piece by Vivaldi. This is the spring movement. We're still not in the right season or the right time of day, but I'm trying. We're working on it. This is the spring movement of the Vivaldi Four Seasons. This year, we actually, our concertmaster Daniel will be playing the entire Four Seasons at a new series that we're doing at the Avon Theater in Avondale, I guess, the Lake District. So this is the first movement of it, and it's interesting to see how Vivaldi uses the instruments to sort of mimic nature. You'll hear some birds going on, might sound like a little bit of a string back in the cello and viola section for a little bit, but it's just really a lovely piece, and we hope you like it. Such a cheerful piece. I always like to play that one. So now we're going to take it down a little bit of a notch, and we're going to play a very beautiful piece by Fauré, French composer Fauré. It's the Pavane. It was originally a piano piece, and then he himself orchestrated it for orchestra, obviously, and choir. And it's just a really lovely, peaceful, calm piece, and we hope you enjoy it. We are also doing that piece later in the season on one of our Masterworks pieces. So if you'd like to hear the orchestral version, it will be available. Important to have the right music in front of you. Thank you. Isn't that a pretty piece? So I looked up because I thought, well, it would be interesting to see what the lyrics that the choir is singing when they sing with us. And it's actually, it's kind of a battle between different loves. And the very last line, I've got it here just to make sure that I get it right, is the translation, of course, it's in French, but is farewell and good days to the tyrants of our hearts. So, you know, a little bit darker than I thought it might be. So the next piece that we're going to play is a piece that was originally for piano by Schumann, and it's called Kindertsänen. He wrote little pieces that mean childhood scenes. And again, I'm not doing very well on the right time of year because the one we're going to play is called Am Kamin, which means at the fireside, and that doesn't sound very nice right at the minute. Give us another few months and it'll be nice. So this is Schumann, Kindertsänen, and the Am Kamin.
Thank you.
time so we aren't late for lunch, the very important lunch. So the next piece that we're going to play is a piece by Bach. It's a gavotte. It's from his third orchestral suite. He wrote four orchestral suites, and this is from the third. The second suite is a favorite of mine. It's the one that's for flute and strings, and I've always loved that piece. This one doesn't have flute in it in the orchestral version, so I'm very happy to get a chance to play it in this arrangement. So this is a gavotte by J.S. Bach. So now we're going to move out of the strictly classical era, although I really think these next two pieces that we're going to play could be classified as just as great of a music as any Mozart or Bach. We're going to play a couple of pieces from the early 1900s, 1920s. We're going to play, It Had to Be You, probably most famous in modern days from the movie Harry Met Sally. It was the soundtrack for that. And then Someone to Watch Over Me, which is one of my just favorite all-time standards. Originally, it was from a Gershwin musical called O.K., as in the person's name, K-A-Y. Never have seen the entire musical, but I certainly love this piece. So it's going to be It Had to Be You and Someone to Watch Over Me. And anyone who wants to sing along, please join us. We would love that.
Thank you.
I was sure I was going to knock over the stand sometime today. It might happen still. So we are down to our last little piece before we send you off to what I'm sure will be a delicious lunch. If this has whetted your appetite for hearing some more live music, the Alabama Symphony starts with their Masterwork Series the last week of this month. Lots of big favorites, Mussorgsky, Ravel's Pictures at an Exhibition. Yakov Kosman is playing the Ravel left-hand piano concerto. If you ever wondered what you could do with just one hand, that's something to see. And that's the last week of this month. If you need something even sooner than that, we have some musician-produced small orchestra concerts this coming weekend. We're playing a concert at Canterbury United Methodist Church on Saturday night at 7:30. I think it's on our website, and then another concert at 3 o'clock at Greater Emmanuel Temple of Holiness Church out east of town a little bit, and we would love to see you. We're playing some Mozart and some Beethoven's First Symphony, some Tchaikovsky, and Wagner's Siegfried Edel. So if you would like to come to that, those are free concerts, and they benefit if you wanted to make donations, local charities. And it's a series we're calling Our Hearts Beat for Birmingham. This last piece is to send you off for lunch, I think fairly appropriately. You're not having tea, you're having lunch, but this is tea for two. And at the end of that, Cantor Robbie will have a couple of words to say, and then you can go have what I'm sure will be a wonderful lunch. Thank you very much for being such a great audience and for having us here. It's truly been our pleasure.
One more hand for our beautiful quartet. My plan was to come up and say, oh, this rendition of One Piece was so beautiful, but the whole thing was wonderful, so I can't even single out anything except to say, the Gershwin brought a lump to my throat, a tear to my eye. It is gorgeous. Thank you so much, all of you. We wanted to dedicate this program to all of those in our community, probably including many of you who have steadfastly supported music at Temple, specifically, as Andy said earlier, highlighting two of our matriarchs whom we've lost in the last couple of years, Joan Jacobson and Ruth Engel. I know that if they were here today, they would have loved every minute of this. Thank you again. Many of you know about these two ladies' love and efforts to support us here at Temple. But what you may not know was that Ruth and her husband were devoted patrons of the symphony and served for many years on their board of directors. Marvin was even so enamored with music and with orchestral music specifically that he wanted to learn how to conduct an orchestra and studied with someone to do so. Joan was equally in love with music and wished to help Temple not only with her time and money, but by lending her beautiful voice to High Holiday Choir, which I wish I could have been there for. She also hosted many gatherings at her own home for visiting musicians and artists in residence, so she was a real gem for our community. She also happened to be on the search committee to bring me here to Birmingham, so I am eternally grateful to her. I am sure that these two ladies and all who have supported music at Temple would be glad to know that there will be many more beautiful musical programs such as this coming to Temple for years to come. And now I am very excited for our lunch, and I hope you are as well. But before we move, let's do our motzi. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam ha-motzi lechem min ha-aretz b'te'avon. Thank you again, Magic City Quartet. And we are in Wheel Hall for our meal.